all your might need to be cut down just a little bit. Amen. Let's just have a word of praise and thanksgiving. I just like feel like praying in the spirit. Amen. Father, we thank you today for your grace, your goodness, your love, your blessings upon us. Lord, you're more than enough. Yeah, more than enough. We give you praise, we give you the glory. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name. Everybody just say, in Jesus' name. Amen. Lord, you're worthy today. And we give thank you, Mashanda. We thank you, Lord, that you are showing yourself strong. On our behalf, we lift you up. We give you the glory that's due your name. We worship you in the spirit of holiness. Oh, God, we thank you. You who have begun a good work within us. You who have begun a good work. You who have begun this good work within us shall continue to perform. Father, we thank you. We give you praise and the glory. In Jesus' name, everybody just say, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. All right, well, we want to continue to admonish you to continue to pray in the Spirit. Amen. Things will begin to happen as you begin to pray in the Spirit. Amen. Okay, all children. In preparation for a test, I'm just going to be released. Amen. All right, I want to share with you briefly. I wish I could do this in 20 minutes. I wish I could.
You can.
Yeah, she's trying to get me. She's trying to get me to get down to 20 minutes. So, to preach your sermon in. So we can develop some more Christianness. All right, so we just want to go as the Lord leads, but we want to. Yesterday I was in Mount Pleasant, Texas, and we were there to do something as a presentation. And it was a big jurisdiction, all of the pastors and ministers and missionaries, all of the leaders were there, and they didn't have a teacher for the preachers in the drug. They didn't have a teacher, and I was talking to the bishop. He said that we don't have a teacher for our men or for the preachers and the pastors. We don't have a teacher, and we tried to get several of them to teach, but they refused because they said they weren't prepared. So I just told the bishop, I said, Bishop, I'll teach him. Oh boy, I just went in there, praise God. Amen. And the Lord just word in my mouth, and I just really enjoyed it. Oh boy, I wasn't prepared, amen, but the scripture says, be ready always. Be instant in season and out of season. When the word is in you, you don't have to look for something to say. Amen. Sometimes you have to try to figure out how you can cut off, but not to find something to say. And I'm talking about holiness. Now, holiness is doing stuff right. How many can say amen?
Amen.
And one scripture that sticks with me from early childhood is Hebrews 12:14. And I want you to quote that for me. Nobody, don't look at it now. Don't look at it.
Yeah.
All right. This is a beautiful one. Follow peace with what? All men and what? Holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Amen. So holiness is very important. We need to know what holiness is. And also we need to know why holiness is so important. We need to really, really know that, because the scripture says if we can't see the Lord unless we are holy, that means that it's very, very important. If you see Him, if you see the Lord without being holy, you would have to be blind, I guess. Amen. Because without holiness, no man shall what? See the Lord. Amen. Now, I'm going to give you some scriptures, and when we say holiness, it means mainly to come to a place in God where your spirit man is in control, control of your mind and control of your body. Because most problems, most sins, and most trouble we will meet is going to start with our members. Amen. It's going to start, the body is your problem. Amen. The body is the problem. And that's the reason why we have scriptures to this effect. I want you to just turn to the scripture that we used last with Hebrews. I mean, it was Romans 12, verses 1 and 2. And I'm going to really get into this today, and I hope I can do it in a short period of time. Romans 12, 1 and 2. This is another scripture that most of us should remember. It says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren. Everybody read that with me. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a what? Living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Presenting your body is something that you have to do. The Holy Spirit is not going to do it without your consent. Is that right? You have to what? Come to a point in the Lord where you what? Present your body. Lord, take my hands, take my eyes, take my feet, take all of me, and I want you to use me to your will and to your glory. You got to present your body. You got to yield the control of your body over to what? To the Lord. Amen. And you do that through the Word and through the Spirit. And by you exerting your will to what? To do or to carry out whatever the Word commands you to do in respect to your body. Amen. Now I want to tell you, it's a real blessing in coming to a place where you can live a life without the dictates of your flesh controlling you. I mean, your prayers will be answered. Amen. If you really want to experience the peace of God that passes all understanding, live a life, amen, that totally, completely, to the best of your ability, yield up to God. Okay, and the second scripture, the second verse, and be not, everybody help me read this, and be not conformed to this world, but ye be ye what? Transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove or demonstrate what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. When you completely present your body a living sacrifice and yield your members, amen, to God as instruments of righteousness, then that enables a renewing of your mind to what? To take place. It's going to take the Word. Everybody can say it's going to take the Word. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by what? Every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. Where my boys at? Bring them up back up there. All my boys. I had about four of them in Sunday school. And we had a good time. We talked about a whole lot of things. All right? And there should be some more children or grandchildren of some of you that should be up here. And we want to really, really begin to focus on these young people because I think it's very important. If you got some grandkids, children, whatever, people that you want to bring on Sunday morning at 9:30, we're going to really teach them how to live a holy life. So I said, I don't think too young to live holy. That's for old folk. Okay. All right. So you got to get it into them while they're young. All right, the renewing of your mind is actually when the Word of God actually begins to dominate and to rule the members of your body. When you begin to line up your physical members with the Word of God, you will experience a renewing of the mind. A whole lot of sins can be averted if we would make the right use of our physical body, out of members. Just about every sin you get into is because your member, what? One of your members were used when it should have been what? Used. It was your mouth. How many know that your mouth can get you out of fellowship? That's one of the main ways of getting out of fellowship is with your mouth. That's the one that the Bible speaks about as the most unruly, what? Member of your body. If you can control your mouth, the Bible says the same is a perfect man. And he's able to bridle his old body. He's able to control his old body. If you can control things that's coming out of your mouth, I don't mean just, you know, cursing and words of strife and things of that nature. I mean your words need to always be lined up with what? The Word of God.
Amen.
You're snared. Everybody say you're snared.
Amen.
With the words of your mouth. The power of life and death is in the what?
Tongue.
And this is where many of us lose control. And when we lose control of our words, you're going to lose control of what? Your members, your other members. Amen. Praise God. Because as long as you say with your mouth, the Lord is the strength of my life. Praise God. The Lord is the strength of my life. Greater is he that is in me. There's another buddy here. Amen. Praise God. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. That builds what? Something in your spirit that enables you to what? To rise above whatever temptation, problem, trial, situation, or whatever the devil brings. You're going to be able to what? Rise above it. Because there is no way that you can consistently agree with the word and actually agree with God in terms of who you are in Christ and still be dominated by what? Your stinking flesh. Amen. You can use your tongue to what? To have you overcome your flesh. But if you don't say anything, if you don't agree with God, if you don't what? Consistently affirm who you are in Christ, then it's going to what? Hinder you from coming to a place in the Lord where your mind is going to be what? Renewed. It takes the word of God. The Bible says, receive ye. Everybody just say, receive ye.
Receive ye. That's right,
Lord. Woo, Lord. Receive ye the what? Engrafted word of God. This is James 1. Receive ye the engrafted word of God, which is able to what? Save your soul. Is that right? All right, so you have to always line up your confessions and agree with God. You know, I tell such this all the time, Brother George. I say that usually when I'm praying, you will notice when I pray, I usually pray the word. If I'm making melody in my heart, I am what? Making melody in my heart with the word.
All right.
121. So, if you keep the word in your mouth, the word will what? Become a part of you. It will what? Get deeply ingrained. If you sing it, if you pray it, if you praise it, if whatever, amen. But if you don't, amen, focus, that's what I focus on all the time. Whatever can build me up, Bible says, great peace have they that love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. Great peace have they that what? Love thy law, and what? Nothing shall offend. In other words, get them distracted and take them from the straight and narrow path. You can perfect. The Bible says, how shall a young man cleanse his ways and live a life that's what? Free and separated from sin. And the Bible says, gives the answer by taking heed to the word of God.
That's it. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. The Bible says, take heed what you hear.
Amen.
Take heed what you hear. Everybody say, take heed what you hear.
Take heed.
Amen. So we need to feed ourselves the word of God so we can, amen, experience that supercharge. Amen. Super anointing.
That's
super joy that God wants to give us. Well, I believe I'm going to have this person in this church today.
Amen.
Boy, I was tired to my bones. I was tired. Bones. I got back in town yesterday. Amen. But the scripture says, the Lord is the strength of my life. I can do all things through Christ that what?
Strengthen
me. And you know, Brother William, whenever I'm weak physically, whenever I'm tired, if I just open my mouth and just what? Just verbalize. I can just say it, or I can sing it, or pray it, or whatever. If it's the word, it's going to what? It's going to pump me up.
Yes, hallelujah.
Greater is he. Woo, Lord. Oh, praise God. Anybody can just say, greater is he. Well, you can put yourself up so high until I'm telling you, you could probably praise God, do, amen, you could do cut a jig almost any time you're called on to do it, or even when you ain't called on to do it. Amen. With joy of the Lord. Everybody just said the joy of the Lord.
Of the Lord.
I think we need more joy.
Yes.
Amen. Everybody in here don't look like you're that happy. I wonder what you've been saying since you left the last time. My sufficiency is of him.
Yes.
Well, I still look like that all the time. Y'all don't think it's nothing to it. I am what I am because of the grace of God.
That's right.
What's wrong with saying that? Amen. When you say things like that, then you get more of whatever you are what? Confessing or saying. Amen. So I just want to encourage you, pump yourself up. Don't live a drudgery life and boring and you're not excited, you're tired, you're running down, you're distracted, you're discouraged. You need to use your lips. You need to use your lips. Your mouth. Amen. The Bible says, caused the spirit of a bad word, caused the spirit to stoop. Yeah, caused the spirit to bow or stoop. But a good word will make you glad again. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Amen. So I'm just warning you, y'all need to say this more than I just almost forced you to say it. Always agree with God in your confession. But all of this other stuff that's popping down is going to create strife and confusion. Amen. The Bible says if you open your mouth wide and say things contrary to the principles of the Word of God, you're going to have destruction. Things are not going to go the way you want them to go. So we need to keep that in mind. So back to James 1:21, it says, receive ye the engrafted word of God, which is able, that's the last part of it. Okay, the first part of it says, put away something. Lay aside all, lay apart all what? And superfluity of what? Nothingness, and receive with what? Meekness, the engrafted word, which is able to what? Save your soul. So that means that we have to separate ourselves from everything that we are doing that's contrary to the word in terms of our speech and our actions, using our members to what? To take us further and further and further. The Bible says, don't use your members as instruments of unrighteousness and for sin. Amen. You better watch what you turn on with your hands. The Bible says, touch not, handle not the unclean thing. Amen. You're not to just, the Bible says, make no provision for your flesh. What? To fulfill the lust thereof. Make no provision for the flesh to fulfill. And we make a whole lot of provision for the flesh because sometimes we just think of stuff that we're going to what? Say. That's what? That's ugly. I mean, stuff that we think about. And sometimes we get so much joy out of what's driving. Gossip and stuff that causes confusion. You're not supposed to use your mouth for things that's causing confusion. You're supposed to use your mouth for what to edify.
Yes.
To build, you ought to build your own self. If you ain't concerned about nobody else, you ought to be concerned about what? Amen. Zip your lips. Don't put your mind in high gear. Don't put your mouth in high gear until you get your what? Mind in what? First. First gear first. Be slow to speak. Oh, Jesus. Slow to speak. Bible says if there's a person that's, okay, why are we in James? I didn't even thought about this. Why? He said, if any man among you seem to be religious, you know, these default, praise the Lord. You know, sometimes I was dealing with a person in the past, not too long ago, and man, every time I talk with them, they're so spiritual. Boy, they said they're right. I said, ooh, this woman is really deep. This person is really deep. Sister Hill and I hope we're talking to them. And every time, well, she almost gives you a message every time you talk with her. And we've been trying to deal with her for about 3 or 4 months to come up with $300 for something that she never had. And she said, and she, every time she called, I'll call you this weekend. I'll let you know, I'll get it to you this weekend. I mean, she's been saying that for I don't know how long. See, these deep folk, they can talk a good game. Right? They can talk about a mile, but they walk it by the inch. Watch these folks now, the people got all these spiritual jargons. They know everything is just, boy, they give the impression that they are just really a Scott Tyler. A Super Sally. The Bible says, if any man among you seem to be religious and bridle not his tongue, but deceiveth his own heart, this man's religion is vain. This man's religion. I didn't write that down. This man's religion. And I'm appalled sometimes as how saints don't keep their word. I know sometimes I fall short, I promise people something, but I always try at some point to let them know the reason why I didn't keep my word.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right.
But sometimes saints will tell you, I'll do this tomorrow. Mm-hmm. I'll bring your $50 over this evening. I'll pay you back next Friday. You never hear nothing else from them. I shouldn't be talking this way. I'm going to get somebody. Be swift to hear and what? Slow to speak. If you know you ain't got no money, next week probably you won't have none and no money's in sight. Don't tell me you're going to pay me back.
That's right. That's right.
And sometimes people can't even squeeze $5 in that budget. Extra. Boy, we use our mouths, I mean, to pull us down so bad. I mean, we just use all kind of ways. All right, let's go back to our James 3 before, because I don't think some of y'all got this last week. We go back to there because the Bible says this is a member that we just can't tame in the strength of our own power. There's nothing we can do to restrain the mouth, because sometimes people just get pleasure out of what? Sometimes telling people off, or making them feel bad, or embarrassing folk, or criticizing people, condemning, or even talking about the pastor, or anybody. They talk about anybody. They talk about you too, brother. I mean, that feels good when they can get out something about somebody. That makes them feel good. It makes them feel more important. All right, James 3. Is that right, Cecilia? I've had a long weekend. 3 and 8, I think. Yeah, tame of the tongue. All right. Okay. No one I think I'm a little bit first Peter. I thought that was kind of strange. Okay, my brethren, being at many masters, let's start with the first verse. Knowing that we shall receive a greater condemnation. For in many things within all, if any man offend not in word, the same as a perfect man, and able also to bridle the whole body. That's the story there. In any man, in many things will offend all, Amen. There are a lot of things we do and the way we act that we use that really cause a lot of people to get offended. If any man offend not in words, but I don't think there's hardly anything that will offend a person more than what the tongue. The same is a perfect man. If any man offend not in word, the same is a perfect man and able also to bridle the whole body. In other words, if you can get control of your tongue, all of your other members will what? Begin to what? Fall in line. Because you can talk your way into what? Acting right, or doing right, or responding right, or saying the right thing if you what? Make a practice of what? Amen. Of what? Building yourself up with your tongue. That's how you build yourself up. With your tongue. See, out of your mouth can come what? Things which build people up, build you up, and things which what? Can tear people down. Both of them come from the same, you have one mouth, right? Both of them come from the mouth. Okay. How many want to be a perfect man and control all of your body members?
Yeah.
When your flesh said, go to the store and get another packet of cigarettes. Nobody here smoke, I don't guess. Amen. That flesh wants what? Wants to smoke. And the Bible says, don't make no provision. Put on ye the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh. And if you make an effort to go and what? To carry out that lust, then you are making provisions for your flesh. And all you have to do is say what? No. Amen. If amen, my body is dead, if Christ be in me, then my body is dead because of what? Righteousness. The Bible says, I'm not debtor to the flesh to live after the flesh. I don't have to do what my flesh wants me to do. I'm not in debt to my flesh. I don't have to obey my flesh. That's what the Bible says. You don't owe the flesh nothing. Why do you have to get up and go and do something that you shouldn't be doing when your flesh tells you? Whoever you serve, whoever tells you to do something and you do it, that's the person what? You are what? Serving. So all you have to do, when you are tempted to let words come out of your mouth, that when you know, the Bible says, let no corrupt words come out of your mouth, but only words that will edify.
All right.
Woo. Then you what? If you obey the flesh, the Bible says, then you are what? You are debtor to the flesh. And the Bible says, they that live in the flesh can't please God. How many can say amen? The Bible says, but those that obey the flesh, if you reap corruption, sow corruption, if we obey and do what the flesh says do, the Bible says we will reap corruption. In other words, you're going to have something tragic, disastrous, going to be happening to you. Amen. So I just want to encourage everybody, amen, to work on your mouth. Work on your mouth, because the scripture said, they that open their mouth wide. I'm going to give you that scripture today later on. For in many things, we just have to read. Now let's go to the third verse. Y'all get this, because the member, this is the most unruly member of our body. So we got to get control of that, because if we don't get control of our mouths, we're not going to get control of our what? Eyes and ears and other members and the flesh. You're not going to get control of it, because it's difficult for you, amen, to get control of your feet. Amen. Your feet say, amen. God said, remove your feet from all evil. The Bible says, flee fornication. Mm-hmm. Flee it. He didn't say, get up and what? Go where it is. Single men, amen, and married men, and women, married women, you don't place yourself in a position where you're going to be tempted.
That's right.
He didn't say run into temptation. He says what? Flee. Abstain from fleshly lusts. Anything that can get you stirred up or to cause you to be drawn away, amen, your emotions to be what? Out of control. Bible says man is enticed when he's drawn away of his own lust and enticed. And when that lust is conceived, it brings forth what? Sin. When you place yourself in an environment, in a place where what? You're going to be tempted. Some say, well, I'm strong enough, I'm deep in God now. I can handle anything. Bible says, have no confidence in your flesh. They had, the Bible says, the circumcision, that's the saints, worship God in the spirit, rejoice in Jesus Christ, and have no confidence in your flesh. Those three attributes that describe the circumcision. Worship God in the spirit. I'm going to say it again. Y'all know what I'm talking about now? Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. I'm going to break it down. Sister Hill said last week I used some kind of use some words that I should have broken down. All right. Worship the Lord in the spirit. And I don't see a whole lot of people. I can see why a lot of people have control of their tongue and their members, because what? They don't worship God in the spirit. They come in to look. Bless the sister Brianna up here just saying her heart out today. Sister Dorothy, amen. She always washes all out. That anointing, you know what I mean? And people just look. We might twirl the thumbs once or twice. I guess they might wiggle the tongue. I can't see the tongues. They might be wiggling them. But, you know, having control, not doing, carrying out stuff that comes to your mind, and getting your members involved in things that don't please God, like going to, what is this place up here, Robin? Keeping a lot of some of used to keep some of y'all broke. Whenever I say the casino, used to keep some of y'all broke when y'all were unsaved. And you obeying your flesh, you can go to the casino and what? See if you can win some money. And there you go. You're using your members. Don't make. The words that don't make provision for your flesh. Don't get your flesh activated and you go, amen, you're going to carry out something, do something that the Bible strictly say what? Don't do. Taste not, touch not, handle not. That means things which are what? Defiled, and the things that's going to what? Corrupt or defile your temple. Because I'm going to tell you, if you drag your body, your members, in the presence of sin or temptation, and when the Spirit is saying, don't go, come here, don't go, follow me. Okay. Spirit is saying, say, don't go. Say it a little louder than that. But I'm going to drag him on in. Whatever he wants to go in, I'm going to drag him on in. And what happens is that all he's going to do is what? It's going to what? Defile your mind, mess up your mind.
That's right.
And it's going to what? It's going to what? It's going to strangle out that spiritual hold you have.
All right.
And it's going to cause what? The spirit to break fellowship. In other words, you just break fellowship. Just go back and the other way. Go back that way. So spirit gone. Because he was drugged in an environment that he didn't want to go. And it's going to what? Mess up your mind. And I mean, all you think is about your flesh. Your flesh just said, oh yeah, man, this is getting good. I didn't know none of this, and I'm teaching y'all. But I was so full of the Holy Ghost, and I worshiped the Lord every time I came to prayer meeting. They said, Sonny, you got to pray through every time you come. Stay on your knees until you get a breakthrough. Breakthrough means that you pray from your heart. You just weep and cry and broken. and you start praying in tongues and things like that. So I just did what the saints told me. And I just, I was there. And I didn't have no desire to do, when I first got saved, most of y'all can say the same thing. When you first get saved, that thing is going to be so strong. That new being in Christ is just so powerful. And it seemed like, amen, I looked at my hands looked near. I looked at my feet, and they did too. And I didn't have no power to, but probably those days you probably lived the best life you ever lived. You had the power to abstain from what? Doing what was wrong. You don't have to ask a prostitute them being in that business for all of the life almost. For instance, you came in here, we just said, well, I know that you've been in sin for a long time, and I'll give you 6 months to turn your life around. She did say, and if you're the Holy Spirit, he said, well, we'll give you 6 months to start getting saved because you've been in sin for so long. It don't work like that, this is the verb. If any man be in what? Christ, he's a what? Amen. Old things what? Pass away, and behold, all things become new. You have a grace to live an overcoming life when you get saved and filled with the Holy Spirit. Because if you don't know the word, or you're not renewed in your mind yet, if you're around the saints, it's going to be enough strength and enough people that pray and know God to carry you until you are what? Amen. Able to what? Go on your own. If you come to prayer meeting, if you come to Bible study, amen, the saints, amen, can carry you, right?
Amen.
So we're just saying that we better watch a whole lot of stuff. No wonder, amen, so many times we fall so short because we want to go with the world. Bible said, don't love not the world. Neither the things that are in it, all that are in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes. See, all of these involved in what? The members of your body. They're not of God, but they are of what? The world is going to pass away. Amen. But the word of God is going to what? Live and abide forever. Amen. So we got to get ourselves even in Philippians 3:3 shape. Okay. Philippians 3:3 shape. Amen. You'll be surprised when you find it. That's the shape that you can master the works of your flesh. You don't have the Bible says, yield your members as instruments of righteousness unto God, not unto sin. Yield your members. Yield your members. Yield your members. That means your mouth, your hands, your feet. Amen. Dancing in the Spirit, praying in the Spirit, rejoicing in the Spirit, reading the Word. That's been bothering your eyes. Amen. Do things that will build you up. Then you won't have to what? Fulfill the lust of the flesh. Walk in the Spirit. You won't have to what? Obey the dictates of the flesh. Walk in the Spirit. Do things. Focus on things that build yourself up. Amen. So that means that you got to what? Utilize your members to what? Build yourself up and to get you out of the realm where sinful things are more attractive to you and more desirable than the things of God. Amen. It takes some work to get beyond that point because I can put some worldly music on right now and some of y'all would just, in your mind, you might not do it verbally or say it, but you just get... So you gotta get past that point where what? Worldly things won't have that attraction on you. Be not conformed to this world, but be you what? Transformed. Amen. And I had some scriptures that I had in place to show that people that don't live pure and holy lives, they don't get revelation from God. The thing, the mysterious thing, the things that requires revelation, like Pauline epistles, which require. Those are deep secrets that he's what? Revealing in those epistles. You just can't grasp that. I've never seen a person that in the flesh really understood new creation reality. That's an area of the Bible that a lot of people just don't get. Because if you understood new creation realities, and that became reality to him. Amen. You're going to go from that realm to a much higher realm. I mean, prosperity spiritually, relationship, everything. Okay. Now, Philippians 3:3, I'm still in James now, but Philippians 3:3 that the other circumcision, they're the ones that love, wishes the Lord in the Spirit. Everybody say, wish the Lord in the Spirit. Everybody raise your hand right now. Let's wish the Lord in the Spirit. I'm going to see if y'all know what I mean. Pray in the Spirit. See, all of y'all together, I barely can hear. Wish the Lord in the Spirit. Say it again. Wish the Lord in the Spirit. Wish it. Come on. Let's wish the Lord in the Spirit. See how quiet it is? Worship the Lord in the Spirit. That's the first step that you take if you want to get control of your what? Your members. I mean, TV watching is mocking your members. Right? All of this junk that we hear and what? Black music, vulgar, stuff that we do on the internet, all of that involves what? Your members. How many can say amen? But if you want to what? Overcome the desire of your flesh that calls your members to get involved in doing things that God is very displeased with. Amen. Because God is only going to reward pure hearts and clean hands. That's all. Pure hearts and what? Clean hands. Amen. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall what? See God. Okay, let's go back to that in James 3. Behold, we put bits in the horse's mouth that they may obey us, and we turn about their whole body. Behold, also the ships which though they be so great, nor driven of fierce winds, yet are they turn about with a very small helm whithersoever the governor listed. Even so the tongue is a little member and boasteth great things. Behold how great a matter a little fire kindle. Amen. One little thing to get out of context and call a world of fire. Because half of the members of the church can what? Be what? Be in strife. Something somebody said and somebody repeated and didn't get it right. I know I'm talking right. Amen. So you have to be what? Very discreet in what? In saying stuff. Don't even let stuff come out of your mind if you think it's going to have the out of your mouth that would have the potential of what? Creating what? Strife. Think through stuff. Slow to speak. Have somebody say, slow to speak. Don't put your mouth in high gear. And when your mind is in what? Neutral first. Man, all of the disturbance I ever seen in church, breakups and splits and all kind of stuff. And more stuff happens in church. All of it usually is what? Words. Mouth. Nobody can tell you. If you don't worship the Lord in the Spirit, rejoice in Jesus Christ. And if the words of the Lord is not dwelling in you richly, amen, you're not going to want to have control of your mouth. You're just going to let it hang out. Whatever you want to say, you think you're big enough to say. Nobody can tell me what to say. My mouth. Amen. But the Bible did say you better control it. Otherwise, you're going to have destruction. All right. You just said 15 minutes of five. All right. Y'all can read that. But verse 8, but the tongue can no man tame. It is an unruly evil, full of what? Deadly poison. Therewith bless we God, even the Father, and therewith curse we men. Now, what I'm just trying to say, I'm not trying to humiliate nobody, but what I'm trying to say, use your mouth to build, to edify, to speak things that will build you up so you will have more control of what your members. Okay, let me just share this with you, and this is about all I'm going to have a chance to say. Now, when we turn to Galatians 5:22, I think that you need to understand this very thoroughly. Galatians 5:22, about the works of the flesh, when we talk about the flesh, we need to understand the flesh involves basically the things that your members get you involved with. The word flesh really means five senses. The things that you see, feel, hear. I mean, using your five senses, your five members, to what? Carry out the will of your flesh, or the will of your desires. Carry out that. Using your ear. Some people like to hear a lot of what? A lot of what? Gossip. Look here. A lot of people like to hear what? They look the hell like to hear a mess. Sometimes they're turning over Aaron, just like the neighborhoods. Hound dog. Amen. Turning over every garbage container in the neighborhood. You know, anybody ever had a problem with dogs? You had all your garbage in the can, and they came up and turned it over, and they got in it, scattered it all over the yard. Nobody ever had that? Years ago, neighborhood town, they don't have it. Today we got better containers. But that's the way it were years ago. Okay, now when it comes to the works of the flesh, Sister Hill, should read that. Now the works of the flesh are these. Whatever.
Okay, then I thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Now the works of the flesh are manifested, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness, idolatry,
mm-hmm.
witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulation, wrath, strife, seditions, heresy, envy, murders, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of God.
Okay, now let's look at that list of sins there, and it could be broken down to seven categories. Look at sex sins, okay, that would be adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lasciviousness. That would be sex sins. Now, lasciviousness is anything that stirs your flesh to a point where you want to commit sin. For instance, like singing, like some songs, some things you view, the internet pornography, all of these things are things designed to stir up your flesh to cause you to what? Commit sin. Once you get at a certain point, in that lustful experience, amen, is equivalent to carrying out the act. Once you say, I don't want to do that, and you look at it and you say, oh man, that sure makes me feel good too. Lasciviousness is anything. That's the reason why some music, as soon as it starts beating and you hear the lyrics, it begins to what? Stir up your flesh and to begin to what? Bring back past memories when you're in sin. So you anything, that's what's wrong with dancing. Dancing now is what? Pretty vulgar for the most part. They're right, it's designed, the average person will get what? Stirred up, and they'll get in that mode where they want to what? Carry out some sexual sin. So anything that stirs you up, if it's pornography, that's going to what? That's going to defile your mind. And it's going to what? Keep you, just keep on pulling you in, sucking you in until you come to a point where you're willing to do it or you actually what carry out. So y'all supposed to flee. Anything that's going to what mess up your mind and cause you to be pulling sin, get you to commit any kind of sexual act. Now even in your mind, the Bible says if you do it in your mind, if you can, you know, if he that looketh upon a girl, a woman, to lust after her, you've already what? Committed adultery. So how many can see that if you worship the Lord in the Spirit, rejoice in Jesus Christ, and have no confidence, don't trust your flesh. Don't let your flesh keep dragging you into stuff, causing you to what? Look at stuff, go here, go there. Amen. Get in an environment where you're going to what? Amen. Have a desire what? To get excited. That's the reason why, Brother Billy, I don't think that really, Sister Hill might help me too, Brother, both of y'all together. How long can a couple go together before they get married without getting in trouble?
All
Depends on where their hearts are. All right, suppose they go to the apartment every night. All right, so do you think they can actually go and kiss and look at each other, stare at each other with dreamy eyes? All right, well, I'm telling you that Bible says what? Flee it. It didn't say what? Go and sit there, sit as close as you can. Feel, rub, kiss, hug. Is that what we call fleeing? Bible said abstain! Anything that's going to get you in lust, I make a pool on your flesh. Abstain from fleshly lust, which wars against your soul. Messes up your mind. After your man dwell on that after a while, boy, after a while, you're going to what? Trying to figure out how you can what? Make that reality. Mm-hmm. It's getting quiet today. Mm-hmm. All right. Sex. Everybody say sex sins. And it can be committed in your mind, in your heart, even without the physical act being carried out. Everybody can say amen. Amen. Now, lesbianism, homosexuality, all that kind of stuff comes under uncleanness. Bible says these people will not inherit the kingdom of God. That's what it says. Y'all hear what I'm saying? People that do these things will not inherit the kingdom of God. Okay. All right. Everybody can say it. See, God wants you to, you know, some say God is just trying to cut out all of my fun. What can I do? Can't party. Can't sit close to nobody. Amen. You can't fellowship with believers if they're lukewarm, if they're sexually active, if they got lustful spirits. Oh, I can just go on. Bible said don't keep company with them. First thing I have to say, not in church, not in Bible study. And you, here you are trying to what? Have a close relationship with them? Well, maybe I'm misinterpreting the word of God here. All right. Temperament sins, I don't have time because it's all those bad ones. Suspicion, rage, anger, strife, envy, selfishness, division, murder, gossip. All of those temperament sins come under the area of temperament. Temperament. Sinful temperament. Now, if y'all will study these things out, you have temperament sins, you have sexual sins, you have sins which we call irreverence, sins of irreverence. That means you're putting a lot of things that you do, even yourself, your flesh, before God. Anything that you put before God and it's going to what? Cause you to be impacted spiritually, drag you down, cool you off, cause you to go what? The other way. That thing is going to be a sin to you. Amen. All right, so I'm kind of getting you going, but drunkenness and revelings, that's in the area of physical appetites. You have to also, that's a sin too, when you overindulge in things that relates to eating and drinking. That's important. Amen. How many know that Daniel was a good example of how if you use restraint in eating and drinking, that you'll have better spiritual insight and you will be 10 times more effective than what people that don't do it. How many can say amen? Oh, I have a lot to talk about in terms of holiness because holiness is a broad area. Amen. Y'all understand some of this? I'm saying? A little bit of? There's some good listeners. Everybody's sitting in one of them. Amen. We just going to have to get them to a certain point where they can begin to understand on a larger scale. Amen. But I think that we can do it. We can turn their lives around, and we can get them understanding what it means to be holy and have a renewed mind in Christ. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
How many are ready? Ready to worship the Lord now?
Amen.
Amen. Three.
Amen.
And one of them is an evangelist, a missionary. See, there she knows she's ready. Worship the Lord in the Spirit. We have a circumcision. Now, this should be our motto. Worship the Lord in the Spirit. Everybody just said it with me. Worship the Lord in the Spirit.
Worship the Lord in the Spirit.
Amen. Worship the Lord in the Spirit. I think that we need to put more into what? Worship. Everybody just said, we need to put more into worship.
More
into
worship.
And when we say worship the Lord in tongues, it's not going to look. We need to what? If you believe on me, Jesus said, as the scripture said, out of your belly shall what? The tongue, the prayer language should what? Flow. Everybody just say it should flow.
It should flow.
And the sound of your praise need to be what? Heard. You don't realize how much your body will come under control, your members will come under control, when you lift your voice and begin to what? Praise the Lord in the Spirit. Worship the Lord in the Spirit and rejoice in Jesus Christ. Tell somebody, we need to rejoice. Get rid of these long things. Delight thyself in the Lord and he'll give you what? Fear not, O ye lands, but rejoice and be glad, and the Lord will do what? Great things. Amen. And have no confidence. I want everybody to say, have no confidence.
No confidence.
In your flesh. Don't trust your flesh. Sister Pearl, amen. Is that right? Don't trust your flesh. Even though you might be saved and you might be with somebody that might be full of the Holy Ghost, if you start sitting close to them and rubbing them, and get in the twilight zone, don't have no confidence in your what? Flesh. Your flesh is unpredictable, right? Your flesh will tell you, oh yeah, you can take it. Man, you strong, man. You can go to the disco. You can go out to the club and spread the word. And after a while, see, anytime you drag your spirit into an environment that it don't want to go, it's going to mess up your mind. And after a while, the spirit is going to take off. The other way. Leave you hanging. And doing your own thing. Praise the Lord. Amen. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Have no confidence. You get it, brother? Well, I believe you got it. Have no confidence. You can't do it in the strength of your own power. You gotta worship the Lord in the Spirit. You gotta what? Rejoice. Half of your temptations and problems and whatever you're dealing with will go away if you just learn how to rejoice. That's what I mean rejoicing. Let's all stand. Hello.